नीचे दिए हुए लाल बटन पर क्लिक करके इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और घंटी के बटन को क्लिक करना ना भूलें। BKT मीडिया प्राइवेट लिमिटेड।
नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द टॉक सीरीज विद यूनिकनेस चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स द ग्रो गियर्स। इट इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय द कमिटी फॉर मेंबर्स इन इंडस्ट्री एंड बिजनेस द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया।
ICAI मेंबर्स आर नोन एज द कंप्लीट बिजनेस सॉल्यूशन प्रोवाइडर्स एंड विद देयर वाइड रेंज ऑफ नॉलेज एंड एक्सपीरियंस दे कैन प्रोवाइड वेरियस प्रोफेशनल सर्विसेज इन द एरियाज रेंजिंग फ्रॉम अकाउंट्स टू ऑडिट, प्लानिंग टू प्रोडक्शन, marketing to sales, tax to information technology. Not only this, they are also highly competitive in the emerging fields like mergers and acquisitions, management consultancy, forensic accounting, business advisory, business viability study, fundraising through private equity, through IPO, FPO listing, and so on. This is how CAs are considered as the custodians of public interest and welfare, as they discharge all their responsibilities in the best interests of the nation.
Friends, the journey of success starts with the first step that you take towards achieving your dreams. That first step, the first kickstart. But sometimes people get scared of the worldly attacks made by others on them and they lose their self-confidence. But at that time, we need to remember that self-confidence is the key. If you don't have the opportunities lying in front of you, then build the door of opportunity. This is not just going to boost up your self-confidence, but it is also going to pave path for the others who are going on the same line of action and just following you. My dear friends, today we are going to meet a personality whose business has now the global imprint. I am talking about the founder and chairman of IIFL. Let's go and meet CA Nirmal Jain. Come on.
Nirmal Jain is an Indian billionaire businessman who is a rank holder chartered accountant and cost accountant. He started his career as a commodities trader and later expanded the wings with his equity research company, providing research on Indian economy, businesses and corporates. Over the years, the company has diversified its business model while remaining focused on the core domain of financial services. A first-generation entrepreneur, a visionary and a market leader, Nirmal Jain is truly an inspiration to the budding entrepreneurs with the acute qualification of a chartered accountant.
So right now we are here in the office of CA Nirmal Jain, and as you can see that there are many rooms lying over here. It's a big office, I must say. And we are just going inside and seeing that which room is assigned for us so that we can talk to CA Nirmal Jain. Come on, let's go. My dear friends, today we are going to meet up a personality about whom, if I would say that he was probably the first man to bring trading on the digital platform, so that is not going to be wrong. Sir, most welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me here.
So firstly, I would like to ask you that, as I have told my audience, that probably you are the first man to bring trading system online and on the digital platform, because you launched its first website, online trading website, in 2000, if I am not wrong.
Yeah, that's right.
But you started in 1995 with an equity research company. So what was the need to come on digital after 5 years? But if we see like that point of time, so it was very initial.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's very interesting. 1995, when I started the research, equity research, it was a new concept in India. And prior to starting this, I had set up and I'd worked with Motilal Oswal, who's also a very prominent broker.
We had an episode with him as well.
Yeah. So I was fortunate to set up his equity research and work with him and Ramdevji very closely.
Okay.
And then I thought that there's a need or there's a vacuum and requirement for independent equity research. So if you recollect, India's reform started in 1991, and in 1994, foreign investors started coming into India.
Right.
This is the first time when people realize that there's a requirement and need for formal research or equity research which is done in a professional and an organized way.
Yeah, in a more organized manner.
Yeah, so we started that point in time. Internet was still not very well known. And there was a heavy mobile phone that people used to carry and pay 16 rupees per minute.
16 rupees ka call hota tha. I do remember that.
To wo ek alag zamana tha. And what we could see, I and my colleagues and a very small team that we were, that internet is going to democratize information in a very big way. And broking also. And we thought that rather than doing it on a piecemeal basis, let's do it whole hog and, you know, take a plunge wholeheartedly. And that is what worked. But what, you know, I could do this, and what was clear at that point in time, because I wanted to be focused on financial services.
Okay.
And financial services is something where I have a core strength, because by education, I'm a chartered accountant, cost accountant.
Yes, of course. That is why we are doing this episode with you today.
I'm aware. So an MBA in finance. So I had a very strong academic foundation of finance. I had a lot of interest in capital market. And capital markets were freeing up. So you could see that maybe next 20, 30 years of your career, you'll see exponential growth in Indian financial services. And that's what fortunately has happened.
So, sir, the foresightedness that you had at that point of time, do you see that being brought up because of the chartered accountancy degree that you did?
There's no doubt that if you want to do anything in financial services, chartered accountancy course probably is very important. Because this lays the foundation in terms of academic and conceptual understanding, which is very strong.
Right.
And I had done other, you know, I'm, as a by professional qualification, I had done cost accountancy as well as management. Every professional education can add certain dimensions to your talent as well as personality. But chartered accountancy is unique in terms of combination of account, finance, audit, law, and also now certain understanding of systems and data processing. Which actually makes you, which gives you a holistic understanding and picture of what you need to actually in any business for that matter, but more so in financial services.
Exactly.
So if I have to bet on any entrepreneur, you know, given other things being equal, I prefer a chartered accountant because I know that at least he understands account finance and nobody will take him for a ride.
And he knows that language.
And he knows that language and he also has understanding of law. Which is also very essential in, you know, in any business environment.
Exactly, exactly. So, sir, as you have said that you had got this professional degree of chartered accountancy. So that was in the year 1987,
that's right? So I had done my chartered accountancy with my BCom, you know, so 2 years with that, and then and I got a second rank. So everybody was very thrilled and elated, and they thought that, you know, I think this is like a big achievement and now you can start working. But
so if I may please ask, that was the first attempt you cleared?
First attempt, yeah, because you get a rank on the first
attempt. You're a bright student, huh?
Fortunately, I cleared all my exams always in my life in the first attempt.
Wonderful.
All groups and I was second ranker in inter as well as final.
Wow.
So academically, I always did well. So the way the CA course is designed is wonderful because it gives you a very strong academic understanding and foundation along with practical experience.
Yes.
So in a three-year time, it really makes you, it transforms you. So anybody who's a graduate or a BCom, it does CA, that elevation or transformation is absolutely mind-blowing. You know, it's completely
different. If I'll ask you, like, what transformation you felt in yourself before entering into CA Institute and after that?
So before entering into CA student, I was a young kid who was in college or school. I didn't know anything about the real world or the business world. Okay. And within 3 years, probably I had a very good understanding of how businesses and companies work. How enterprises work, how and what is money, and how even frauds and controls, you know, how happen, what, and most importantly, because you meet so many people during your audit and during your articles of training, you tend to learn about interpersonal, how to deal with people outside your family, friends and social circle.
Right.
So I remember those days that 7 to 10 we used to have college, and college used to conduct our classes in a very special manner for those who are doing the articleship. And 10 o'clock we'll just run and take the local to, you know, go to the audit. And audit will be there till 6 o'clock in the evening, typically sometimes late also.
Exactly.
And in the evening we'll do CA classes in Sydenham College, which used to be run by the institute itself, you know. So
my God.
So these were really, really hectic days, but in that young age, you know, because I was just about, what, 18, 19. There was a very good foundation for hard work, and that really helped you know, throughout the year.
And at that time, I particular believe is like you have that power of making 24-hour, like into like reverse counting. You can make it 42 hours for with your work.
If you do your articleship properly, then all the academics or the studies that you're doing, the books that you're reading, it becomes easier for you to understand.
Right.
A lot of it is practical. A lot of it, what you read is also is something which you use it also during the day in articleship.
Exactly. So basically, you are doing your PhD simultaneously, no?
Yeah, you're working because it's like a lab, so that you're doing your experiment also simultaneously, so you learn it very quickly. And that is what really gives you energy to do everything.
Exactly. Those energies are really important.
Absolutely.
So, sir, if I'll ask you that, who gave you that motivation to pursue Chartered Accountancy degree? Because back then as well, yes, this degree holds a very high esteem, but even then you need someone to guide you at a proper level.
So my elder brother was a Chartered Accountant. He was also a rank holder. And so that was actually, so as you grow up in an Indian family, you always look up to your elder brother and then you realize that. And maybe he was actually the first highly educated person in our family.
In your family, okay.
Yeah. So there was really excitement, and then he becomes your model and ideal to follow. So that is how I got into commerce stream and took up CA. And as I started studying for it, I really liked the course.
Chartered Accountancy is considered as the finest degree courses of India. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India continues to update the curriculum while maintaining the high standards of the course. These courses provide holistic understanding of the businesses and market to the professionals. Thus, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India prepares the professionals of tomorrow and ensures that the economy lies in the safe hands. The 21st World Congress of Accountants, known as the Olympics of the accountancy profession, is being hosted by ICAI from November 18th to 21st, 2022 at Jio World Centre, Mumbai. Being held for the first time in India, this is one of the most prestigious global events of professional accountants organized under the aegis of the International Federation of Accountants, where a conglomeration of 6,000 delegates from over 130 countries exchange views with the other accounting and finance professionals from around the world.
So, sir, this Chartered Accountancy degree, as you said that when you have that kind of professional degree, then you are very good with your organizational thing and along with that in like all your figures and everything. So how this thing is helping you out while maintaining this financial services platform?
I think it's very helpful. There's no doubt about it. I don't think that anybody can ever underestimate or underplay the importance of Chartered Accountancy qualification in running a business.
Yes.
One is that, you know, understanding of accounts and finance is very important. So even when the new laws and new things come, your foundation is strong in terms of academics, so you can learn them fast. Two, the financial services business is hugely compliance driven and there are legal regulations. So I think that if you have studied law as a part of your chartered accountancy, in particular Income Tax and Companies Act, it becomes easier. Because many times when I find my MBA friends, it's very difficult for them to understand, digest, or even read the language which is legal.
Yes.
Or because, you know, they haven't been trained into that, or they never had an opportunity as a student to learn it.
Right.
And apart from that, even audit, which, you know, helps you build controls, checks and balances, which is so important in financial services. See, in financial services today, if you can do the risk mitigation and compliance, at least, you know, I would say you're home.
Wow.
But what is more important is how do you manage your risk? And how do you make sure that you're 100% adhering to the compliance?
Yes, and that is important as well.
Absolutely. Because regulatory framework is very strict.
That's right.
And nobody can be on the wrong side of it.
Exactly. So, sir, as if I talk about like your organization, so it is basically having like investment not only like from like India, it is also having the investment from the Canada. It has also got the investment from the like UK government's equity firm. And sir, as you said, that CA degree, when you have that professional degree, it is very easy to understand the compliance and just get on to it. And especially when you are having this kind of international exposure, I think understanding their compliance as well becomes very easier.
Absolutely. So as a professional qualification, I can say that CA is probably the more holistic than any other qualification for that matter. And probably, you know, 30 years ago, we could not have imagined that how important the compliance and the legal understanding or the law understanding of law, although we can always hire good lawyers all the time.
Yeah.
We can have legal consultants. But if you have a good understanding, it becomes so much easier for you to talk and, you know.
And you can take right decisions at the right time. So are there any significant moments that you feel that that really helped you to gear up for this particular course? Because it is not an easy course. Yes, it is difficult. But if you have that passion, you can clear it. As you said that you cleared it in the first attempt, that's really good. So can you share some of those stories with us?
So what happens in a CA, many times people misunderstand and they think that they have to mug up. They have to just, you know, like ratta maro and, you know, clear the exam. I think it's a bad approach. And I could do CA, ICW, everything together and still get a good academic performance because maybe I got right approach with good professors like Professor N.P. Sarda, or, you know, we had in our college Professor Kisnadwala, who's no more. But they've been really outstanding and exceptional in making you understand the concepts.
Yes.
So even people think that law is what? Law is your mug up. No. The law is something which is logical, which is commonsensical.
Yes. I mean,
supposing you have to write law, you are the king, you will write certain law for everybody to follow. It has to have some logic, some common sense.
Exactly.
So if you understand the intent of the lawmaker, it becomes so much easier for you to connect and understand and then remember.
Beautiful. And it is rightly said by CA Nirmal Jain that if you really want to do something in life, or if you really want to understand the business or the core of any law, it's you need to have a kind of common sense with you. But that is also very true, that common sense is not so common. So we need to really develop it and we really need to work on it. So, sir, how those aspiring chartered accountants can work on that? Because actually they have just come from a like background, abhi unka 12th ho gaya, unhone acche se padhai kar liya, but now they are coming forward for a professional degree. So what are the traits that with whom they have to come to on that platform so that they can just go in the flow of this degree?
See, first is that many of these are, they are already, they are scared. Unko dara diya jata hai ki bahut padhai hai. It's like bahut really overwhelming. Ki there are such so many fat books and laws, you know. So first of all, they need to, anybody who wants to be aspiring chartered accountant should know that there are lakhs of people who have cleared this exam, okay?
Exactly.
So it can't be inhuman, otherwise, you know, so many people would not have done it.
Exactly.
So that's the first thing, because if you are scared, then you will always have a fear psychosis. So even when you are, you know, you start working 16 hours, 18 hours, mugging up, that's a bad start.
So you have two options, na? Either you see one person, arey wo nahi kar paya, mujhse bhi nahi hoga, ya phir arey itne logon ne kiya hai, main kar sakta hu.
Right. So first of all, you have to make a balance in terms of how you want to eat, your physical activities, and then studies. And then you should like it. You should have interest. If you like finance, you like commerce, you like business, you like numbers, you like economics, then you'll really learn it very quickly.
Wow.
But all the CA courses are all practical. And you're going to use them in real life, okay? They're all practical. And therefore, it's very easy to develop an interest and full involvement in those courses if you have, you know, the right attitude.
Sir, if I would ask you that you need to give a piece of advice to all the aspiring chartered accountants, what that would be?
I think one very important thing is that never ever compromise on honesty or integrity. Never go for shortcut to make easy money. Because in this business, there'll be a lot of temptations.
Yes.
Don't do that. Because if you don't do that in the long term, not only you'll make more money and wealth, but you'll have a lot more respect for yourself, as well as a much better life to live.
Right. So, sir, any suggestion for the members in industry and business? Because this committee is organizing this basically talk show.
So, I think members in industry should know that in last, you know, sort of 30 years of reforms, so many more opportunities have opened up for chartered accountants.
Yes, a lot more.
So 30 years ago, CAs would look at the profession from a narrow glasses of audit, tax, and a little bit consulting. Today, CAs can do a lot more. They can be entrepreneurs. They can be part of technology, digital transformation. So I think what our members should know that many new avenues and vistas have opened up, and you should try and, you know, seize that opportunity.
So, sir, what do you say, like, when Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, like, they have designed this course for the all the budding chartered accountants, and especially the students who really are coming up with the dreams. So you see ICAI fulfilling those dreams, because I can see your dream being fulfilled.
Yeah, it's fulfilling the dream. And I think it's important for the committee to make sure that the curriculum is kept up to date. And even if there are pressures or, you know, to make it easier or improve the success rate, But I think there's a trade-off between being more gentle and nice to people who are appearing for exams and maintaining the highest standards and the respect for the professional degree that it is. So the high standards are very important, because unless you clear your the toughest of exams, you really aren't capable enough, and you won't carry the weight and the stature or the respect and confidence of the society. So I think you really have to maintain the highest standards, what this profession has always commanded respect for.
That's really true, my dear friends, because whenever we talk about the success, we need to understand that success is not never going to lower down its standards for us to achieve it, but we have to raise our standard to achieve it. And sir, I would really like to say that you have raised that bar, and today you are on such a position where you are giving a lot of opportunities to others as well. Thank you so much for
joining
us.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you so
much. And I thank the Institute also for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
But before I bid a goodbye to you, here is a special segment that I call Shilpa Bhavna Special. So it's a rapid fire round. So I'll be firing some questions and you have to answer.
Okay.
So I'll say some words. Usko sunke jo aapke dimag mein pehla shabd aata hai, that you have to say.
Okay.
So.
But then once I say that, then you move to the next question.
Yes. 100%. Mm-hmm. Chartered Accountant.
Proud to be one.
Institute of Chartered Accountants of India.
Great institute.
Committee for Members in Industry and Business.
Doing well.
Financial Services.
The best industry to be in.
And see in Nirmal Jain.
A humble man.
I would agree to that.
You do that again?
See in Nirmal Jain.
Yours truly.
Thank you so much. Friends, every success story is a tale of constant adaptation, revision, and transformation. And this consistency in doing so leads to the growth of an individual, the growth of an organization. And especially when this is done by a professional, especially the chartered accountants, I can say that this growth is not just for an individual or the organization, but also for the growth of the society and the growth of the country. After having a candid chat with CA Nirmal Jain today, undoubtedly I can say that chartered accountants are the growth gears. This is Shilpa Bhavna signing off for today. I will see you next time. Till then, take very good care of yourself. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.